Reuters. G'day mates, it's trumpetmonkey. Happy Sunday. Monday Night Football tomorrow. Week 2 Just Win Baby episode. And man, I'm nervous. I'm both ecstatic and excited to watch the first ever home game in Allegiant Stadium. I'm amped. Make sure you're following on the Twitter. We retweet all the best Raiders stuff we find. But anyway, 5 keys to how we can win. Number 1 for me is actually all about the perspiration, all about the mental side of it, the effort side. And that is, use the energy, use the occasion. We heard about Jonathan Abrams bringing like the energy, even though it was an empty stadium versus Carolina. Like, I want to see that this week. I think it's going to be phenomenal. You're looking at footage here of like From the Ground Up episode. Such a cool like series, by the way, on how like Allegiant Stadium was built. But it's going to be an empty stadium, just like in these shots. That doesn't mean that the players can't come out and just use that energy, because this is an historic moment. And so I say use the passion. Like, normally you're asking your players not to get too emotional. Honestly, I think the Saints are the more cohesive unit, and I think they're the better team. They are. I mean, come on. Like, historically, based on just last season's performance. And what that means is, like, it's going to take Herculean effort. So I want to absolutely see that. And but that doesn't mean that the Raiders can't win. I just think it's going to be a shootout, and it's going to be crazy. So use the energy. That's number one. Embrace the emotions of the occasion. Definitely. Number two for me is pass rush. I think the lads like have all said that the pass rush wasn't as good as we wanted it to be last week. And I think we have a hungry D-line. We absolutely do, who should be getting more sacks. Honestly, I believe that we are going to put so much pressure on Drew Brees. He's going to have to get that ball out really, really quickly. And I don't think he's going to take too many deep shots, which means we're going to be able to play like cover one, cover two, I hope, for the entire night, and like really force some mistakes. Now, we saw that the secondary, I still want the team to go get Earl Thomas III so badly. But we saw that the secondary is pretty solid. A couple of mental errors. The pass rush is going to help that, especially if they're like Johnny on the spot, okay? And they got their heads on swivels looking for those picks. I expect the pass rush to be like dominant this week. Expect that. 100% it needs to be for us to win. Number three. Deep shots. This guy right here, Derek Carr. We're going to need play action. Now, this is awesome stat from NFL.com. 44 straight games, the Saints have not allowed an individual 100 rush yard performance. So that means Josh Jacobs has like, he has a slog of a game ahead of him, but we're still going to feed him. I want to see him break that streak, A. And then B, I'm worried about Ruggs and how long he can last in the game. So just like last week, I think on the second play from scrimmage, we bombed it deep. I want to see that early and often with Derek throwing the ball deep. And also, definitely, I love this tweet right here, using from NFL Films, using Jacobs in the pass game as well. You know, I want to see some like deep, deep shots. I want that defense creeping down, and then we take the top off. That is going to be leading into point number four. Derek Carr needs a mistake-free day. That deep shot he took on play number two of last week, Ruggs was open. That's open in the NFL, and Derek missed him, okay? And he actually threw a little short on the big drag play from Carolina, where Ruggs could have had a tutty if he'd let him. So Derek needs a mistake-free game. Historically not very good on Monday Night Football. 5 touchdowns, 6 picks total, 10 fantasy points. Derek has sucked on Monday Night Football. That doesn't mean he can't be awesome, though. All right? So deep shots on play action is number three. Derek Carr being mistake-free and not sucking on Monday Night Football. We love you, Derek. You're our QB. That's absolutely vital as well, okay? And then number five, and this is big because we don't know who our right tackle is going to be. Trent Brown, I don't think it's working. I got to tell you, I don't think it's working. The guy can't stay on the field. I'm concerned. It's Cam Jordan is number five. Cam can line up and he can rush from both sides. He can rush from DT as well. They let him move around as much as they want, right? But our right tackle is going to have to be awesome. Wherever Cam goes, whoever is matched up against him is going to have to do the job. This is a big game for Colton Miller. If he decides to go to right end, big game for Colton Miller. So containing Cam Jordan is my number five. I guess, key to victory for Just Win Baby Week 2. Let me know what you think in the comments section below. Am I being too harsh on Trent Brown? Am I being too harsh on Derek Carr on Monday Night Football? Am I kidding myself? Am I kidding myself that we're actually going to have a good pass rush and we're going to throw the ball deep? Let me know in the comments section. Enjoy Sunday's games, mate. I'll be watching here from Europe Monday Night Football about 4 a.m. for me. It's going to be epic, and I'll see you lads soon. Let's go, Raider Nation. Woo! Hype, dear Raiders!